New Revit update is out, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how to download and install the update and also some of the new features for Revit that we get. Let's go! Now quickly before we get started, I would just like to ask you to check out my website balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about mastering Revit, that's definitely the best place to be. We are an Autodesk authorized training center and we offer over 150 hours of Revit dedicated content to learn about all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight to, well, the Autodesk website. So here we are at the Autodesk website. Obviously you have an account if you have Revit, and then you need to go to product updates over here in order to update Revit. Now once you get to product updates, you want to scroll down and search for Revit 2026.1 update. So here it is. It has been released on May 22nd. So I'm just going to go here and download this update. So it's going to start downloading the file. And once the download has been completed, you can just click here and start the installation process for this update. It's going to ask you to allow it to make changes, and then it's going to prepare the installation. Now here, you just need to click on Install Update, and it's going to start the update installation process. And after waiting for a couple of minutes, we are finished with this update. So now, once this is done, we can start up Revit 2026.1. And when we open up Revit, what you'll notice is that here we have Revit 2026.1. So this isn't a big update that we get every April each year. This is a smaller update. We usually get these every 3 to 4 months. It might be a good idea to update if you're interested in just keeping up to date and getting all of the latest features. Now I'm just going to open up the sample architecture project for this demonstration of the new features. So the first update has to do with the accelerated graphics tech preview. So that's this feature that we have over here. So something that you should be able to notice once you start this up is that now it should be running about 15% faster than it was with the original Revit 2026. So that's kind of a minor improvement. It was already fast, now it's a little bit faster. So that's just something to keep in mind. Also, I didn't really notice any updates in terms of removing some of the limitations that the accelerated graphics tech preview has. So that's just something to hope for the next update. Then moving forward, we have an update in terms of referencing views. So for example, here, if I decide to reference a specific view with a section, elevation, or a callout, for example, so I'm just going to create a callout and then say, okay, I want to reference a particular view and then create that callout. So now with this new update, when we have this callout and we have the callout head, and here we have the basically, this is a parameter, the reference label parameter. Now we don't have to actually fix it here in the properties or go into edit type or anything like that. Now it's all in Canvas. So you just click and edit this text over here. So that's a very useful feature. Moving forward, when it comes to shortcuts, we have some new capabilities now. So if you're working with documentation heavy workflows, this is going to be really useful. So when you go here to keyboard shortcuts, what you'll find is that we have now more options. So if I go to edit schedule, for example, now this is a command which we can use to assign a shortcut to. We can also do this for opening views, navigating between views or sheets, moving elements and other parts of the documentation workflow. Also, when it comes to this documentation, we have some new double click behavior. So for example, if I go here to the file menu and then go to options and go to user interface and find the double click options. For example, now if you click on views on sheets, you can activate the view, but you can also set it to open the view as kind of as a separate tab. So this is something that's also useful if you're working a lot with documentation. Now, moving forward to some structure updates. So if I go here to analyze and go to structural analytical model and open up load cases and combinations, what you will notice is that now we have this automate function. So this allows you to automate the load combination creation based on the available design codes. So this is something that's going to be useful as well. And also, when it comes to rebar, now if you select rebar, what you'll notice is that you have these arrows that indicate the start and end of rebar, and you can use them as sort of flip arrows to basically spin this the other way around. So this is a really useful kind of in canvas functionality that we now have. And believe it or not, that's pretty much it when it comes to this update. So these smaller updates are really, really small. So there is not too much to talk about, but I think it's important to just keep up to date when it comes to the new features that we have in Revit, because we can easily overlook these and end up not using a very useful feature. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.